to stop and then you should go into this new year. You should always, as they say, to reflect deeply. And specifically, especially in the beginning of the new year, I want you to reflect deeply on where you've been, where you've come from, what you know. And I also want you to ponder the themes of the Bible. And I'm going to open up the door to us this morning and show you that we can guide our lives this year on the themes.
In the temple or in the holy places,
not going to be anymore. It's frozen. But the last six hours is not this one. So if you have been in the middle part of the cell, it's not going to be in the second part of the cell. Now, if you think about what's going on with this problem now, it's about your value being taken and being taken. It is going to be not going to be anymore. And all of a sudden, it seems like the bloody blood of these promises that you're living around that is fruitful, that you're deep in the place, that you're very consistent with your life, seems like it's not going to be. And you can really drive these people if you're in their home. Just think about that in circumstances where what they see, what they feel, and what they feel is not them dying, but that it's maybe not to be because they're going through some serious, serious outcomes. Now, in dire conditions, I often look for a sign that is around it. And so, when the man is called bigger conditions, which goes from someone 58 all the way to Psalm 157. Psalm 157, verse 4, asks the question, how can you worship in a sovereign way? And then what follows from 157, which is actually 8 to 8:45, are things that were written for worship in a sovereign way. Okay? So this is not just Psalm that is making no tempo, no physical, visible manifestation of great presence, no prosperity, no abundance, no nothing really that the person is in the same country. And in this collection of songs that is made of song, when things shall worship God in these circumstances, and we will show you why. That's the key message of this song. It's not a matter of mindful, but a matter of experiencing our mind shall worship God, and let me tell you why. So what the Western exchange is called doctrine. It's theology. It's what we believe about God. Remember the last week I said it's a prayer of trust. Last week, the Western is an explanation of what these people believe about God in those days, taking us through the early benediction. And it's filled with beautiful, beautiful truth. And when they come from the place where people might be changed in their faith, Thank you. That's why I ask the question today. The moment you ask the question, you know the word no, you always know the word no. Because why am I saying, do you really know? Do you really know? Knowing is so very, very intimate, very, very personal. Compel, opposite for you to describe the totality of God's glory, to God's truth, in verse 2, to down, and then stand up, not only from the truth of peace, to work, to truth of joy, to go. It's all meant, it's a language from the top, a kingdom language, to come out of specific meaning. And that is to describe the totality of God's glory. What I want you to see in these first two verses is the very personal paradigm, you. To find a call someone, you will go to the relationship of knowing and intimacy. Think about calling someone by a title, think about calling someone by their position. That's what intimate relationship is. Because if you are able to speak to someone and engage someone, that is what kind of relationship is. It is one personal calling, and that is you. It's such a deep level. That God knows is unique to the world as well, and that may be the so you think about the depth of the knowledge of God when it comes to us. And even knowledge is very important in the same way. Now, the consequence of God knowing us in that way is that we cannot hide from God. One benefit of that is that God brings in human beings. He brings in the power of God. One human being covering from all sides. You can either go forward or backwards in relation to God because I feel covered from all sides. That is the way that God covers human beings with his presence from all sides. Therefore, we cannot hide because he is in front of us, behind us, he is for us, and in front of us. And that is a fantasy. Why? Because that speaks of God's protection. I don't know about you, but if you are a new girl, teach me too long to work. And you are a victim of the year. And see how you actually are to buy a teaching to keep the world. It's unbelievable. It's like a potential superpower. Because you are going to keep that. But somehow, you just gather your friends and your God in such a way that you can expand on that now. As a candle, the truth from all of us. Because if you hold your word, to the front of the fire. The fire is filled by the fact of alignment. And what the psalmist says is a lot of the just the knowledge of the experience of this is so much for me to complete. Such verses be, the author says, that the wondrous knowledge is beyond me. It is elastic and unable to reach it. In Hebrew it says, I don't get it. You know what I mean? You say, you get it. But I would say, I get it. That's unattainable. Now my grasp is sunk all these things that are difficult. And that is what I believe about God. That verse is 1 to 6. One, nine. Now if I happen to receive that for the discussion question of the day, I actually see that I could understand you. And it would be really, really true. Because the awareness of who knows is based on knowledge. It's someone else, it's ever present and everlasting, who knows us to a wide deeper level than any human being who is a knowledge. And that is how it stands. And now the psalmist asks the question, why can I see him? Which seems like a funny question to ask because in just four of those kinds of determinants, why is this true and covers us completely? So what one could do, then how is it possible that I could see from there? Well, remember that the writer of this poem puts in a situation that might sometimes feel or look like God is not there. And that's why he asks this question. And can you see up to six for the same reason? Can you see up to the heavens? Can you see down in the underworld, down to the kingdom? Can you see east? Can you see west? Once again, not another point, but I've got another side of my thinking in my reflection to really make sure that God is in a prison and that it is in heaven. Now, see, I am really there in these verses, verses 10 to 12. And And that was what we were doing. So we were first time I saw her, I was thinking, speaking about and then we would get out of the what we would have to do to actually believe. That's why that was the element of surprise. Even if the writer is trying to find themselves in the event, it's not the other way or the other way, but it's just trying to sit in the middle of the table and talk to them about how he says, God will say, recognize the final sources of even further, to that small that we know, a far into some ways, to the sense of immeasurable, and God is new. It's like nothing, it's a part of this thing, because everywhere I go, I find it still, I find it power, I find it salvation, I find it assistance, I find it guidance. So the psalmist really starts with us to think, God, that we are coming to experience, and think we will see, and then write exactly the same thing. And that is the end of the prayer of these emptiness. When I was at the corner, I had to think to myself, work with me instead of that. Let's fly over the world and see the God is and where God is at. You can please reflect in this place. And as impossible as it might seem, even that is possible for the other, for the God in the for the God in the world. Might have the power of the poet, that does nothing. Look at this life. Even the darkness is not dark to me. That is an impossible statement. Human beings come up to that. Body, darkness is not dark. Light not means dark, because darkness is dark. But this kind of dark light means darkness is not dark. Even the darkness is not dark to you. The light shines like a day. Darkness and light are alike to you. Why did the light of the sun say this? Because in darkness, like what I am telling you, darkness is too. The darkness is what I am not sure what God is doing out of me, but that is your God's face. It has to be eternal. Far away, far away from the world, far away from you deeply, far away from you, all has nothing to do. So, no money, and I can't see something. How does that make you feel? This is totally different. I'm trying to think, but look at this. How does that make you feel? How does that make you feel? And make you feel loved, covered, dreamed of. You've suffered from love, but it is good. Not look at verses 13 to 18. In this, as I put up a slide earlier, I'm actually reading all the time for every point. So, can you just go towards the you know yourself, the qualities, saying this, I think that I thought yours, my God. Ask yourself at that point, you know me, God, will it work with me? And it's back to the second point. Someone see me, know me, with the little bit of that mark and the truth, and I so that is something to help you. How does God know this? That's the question. It is no use. I can't see something. How does this come to be? It is a question that this colossal, father, God, all powerful God, knows everything about me. And here we are. This is so to help you. God is the one who generates human life. You would know, and you might have seen this, that this is a very intense, hard, focused way to get a piece of clay in the earth, to get a pan on the moon, and then to sit. It's not so different from the time of the world this time. It's magnificent order of the supervisor of the world. It's not so much that they discovered what they were going to do. And one of the correspondents would bring back and pick up the information. That's why they went out to space. I said, no, 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 no. And I had to watch me go out of it. And I can't find the man. I'm telling you what you do to protect me, to serve me, and to keep me.
Thank you.
comes to 900. But if it's 900, you see parts that keep parts to the same amount. And that's what the same body is called. That's what I'm doing. So this is 900. That's the starting point. The power from the pilot is normally searching for honesty. Not you. I'm asking you, guaranteeing you, that you should question, searching, and knowing. Why? Because when you do know you, you're questioning and searching. I want to make sure that there's no sense of error. I want you to know you. Because the same thing is in a powerful situation, right? But after this time isn't on a December elevated decision. But after this time is in a very, very tough spot. But after my family wasn't finished, my compel is talking about a study on the everlasting world. And you see what the picture of the world in the first few verses. The first verse is going to be known, and now that you know me, that statement becomes. And some of that statement that God expresses is that he faith God and not everything that is guaranteed is true. Asking, what do you want to deviate from you? You say, no, the God that first of all, and who gave you that? The way that you start, what you see from the center of God. You think about us in the beginning of the year. Isn't this the God that you want? What if our prayer this year becomes, lead me in this silent district. Help me in this little mountain. Let me not deviate from your way this year. And I'm asking you to know God is me. To know me in silence. Stand around the conversation. Open to me. Everything I do, everything I think of, everything I do. So my hope is found in your past this year. Wouldn't God give our year a completely different focus? Wouldn't God give us a completely different energy to take every day and get more together in this room and more than this year? Why? Because we are deeply known and deeply loved by God ourselves. If we are not prepared for the second time, I would say that we are going to look at the life of Jesus to see what it's like if we truly believe this. Now remember, Jesus knew the signs. Jesus knew the signs of our hearts. Jesus prayed at least 3 times a day, reading, reading, and reading. Jesus never had a bad testament, or a bad heart, when he was praying for his heart. He knew the first 5 books of the Bible, but a bad heart when he was studying his heart. The writing of Psalms was always in Jesus' mouth. He prayed it, he recited it, and he was ready to pray. That is a deep knowledge of his truth. I want to tell you the quote from Dallas Willard. It's only a short one. When they know something, when they act as if it were true, it's all done for them and it's going to be. Listen to this. When they know something, when we act as if it were true. Jesus believed this, and he acted as if it were true. When he was a human being. Let me show you a couple of verses. I think it's on the slide. Let's look at Matthew 7, verse 50. Jesus speaks to people and he says, even the walls of your world will hold you captive. So don't be afraid. You are worth more than many souls. How often do Jesus say this? Because Jesus believes in the value of human life. And because Jesus believes in the value of human life, he doesn't have to say anything more. He knows what that is. He knows the blood flow of every single human being in the depth of the womb of his mom. Look at Matthew 6, verses 25 to 26. Well known verses, but just listen to it, but it says, why is this man? That's why I tell you, don't worry about your life. What you eat, what you drink, what about your body, what you do? Isn't life more than food and body than you're clothing? Consider the days of the sun. That is why we leave the body into bounds, but now in the Father sees you. Are you, aren't you, not more than that? He believed it, and he acted as if it was true. Let's look at Luke 15, a confident in our work and our community. And we are thankful that even when we are covered in darkness, we see your strength. Our prayer that we find God's deliverance. Our prayer that we see our words and our hearts now in this moment. And that it will also help us to get out of our own words, God's words, and our comments to God. I pray that you lead us to this truth when we see our message. I pray that you lead us to this truth when we are strangers in our emotions that we don't see you now. That we continue to think that we need to be taken. Thank you.